What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Madden NFL 15. Here we are, week 12, with probably the matchup of the season so far between the 8-2 Patriots and the 9-1 Buccaneers. These two teams are quite the high-powered teams, both offensively and defensively, top five in both categories. And obviously, this is a Thanksgiving preview. This game probably should have been moved to Thanksgiving, because who doesn't want to watch this game? But evenly matched, I mean, this is the question here. How close will this game be at the end? It's going to come up to a couple of big players from either team to decide who's going to be the winner. Right now, we're ranked number one in the NFL, 7-game win streak. Patriots 8-2, they're ranked number 16 in the NFL. And taking a look at their offense, they're led by Jimmy Garoppolo at quarterback, no Tom Brady. And Garoppolo's kind of molding himself into a pretty solid starting quarterback over the past couple of years. Starting at running back, Eddie Lacy, backed up by Lance Dunbar and James White. So the Patriots picking up quite a few running backs or solid running backs during free agency. At fullback, Stanley Havili out of USC. This guy has an 89 overall, and the only reason I show that is because he's got a better overall than all their receivers. Victor Cruz coming over from the Giants, Reuben Randall, Hakeem Nicks, Brett Walters, and then you have Rashad Matthews, who's going to be injured, so we won't be seeing him today, and then Dwayne Harris. So the Patriots picking up a few former Giants receivers after they lost Edelman to the Dallas Cowboys. Amendola's a free agent. And then, of course, we have to deal with Rob Gronkowski, Gronk, at tight end. And Gerald McCoy will still be out for 5 weeks after breaking his collarbone last week in New Orleans. So he'll be back right in time for the playoffs. But we got plenty of depth at defensive line. But it's kind of hard to replace the guy that has a 99 overall and has been such an impact for this team, especially against the run and getting to the quarterback. But we have plenty of depth. Michael Johnson, Quentin Hobbs, and Derek Marks. And then we're always sending linebackers on the blitz. So Kyler Woodyer, Levante David, Xavier Gooden. And then, of course, the pressure from the secondary. I come on the blitz quite often. So really, our defensive pressure today should be fine against the Patriots. But let's see what happens. Let's get this game underway. And welcome back to Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa Bay, Florida, as we have a matchup here in Week 12 between the Patriots and the Buccaneers. Many people have been looking forward to this matchup all week, and some people see this as a potential Super Bowl matchup later this season. Buccaneers and their fans in the stadium today wearing black alternate uniforms as a method of intimidation here against the Patriots, as both teams should have a tough time getting things going both offensively and defensively, but one team ultimately is going to have to win this game. And the Patriots with the ball first as they come to the field here at the 20. Garoppolo under center, handoff for Lacy up the middle. Lacy spinning off a one, and Lacy picking up 9 yards. The hard way on the ground. Eddie Lacy, a tough runner. It's going to take multiple people to take him down. We got to get him down to first contact. Eye formation here for the Patriots. Eddie Lacy led by the fullback up the middle. Good for two. And that's the first down for the Patriots. So no three and out in their first possession. First and 10 from the 31-yard line. Cruz in motion. Garoppolo dropping back to pass. Trying to find a receiver. Firing short for Cruz. This one's caught for 5 yards. And that'll get them down to the 36-yard line. Tackled by Xavier Gooden. 2 minutes into the game here, second down and 5 for the Patriots. Gronk in the backfield as Garoppolo shrugs off one sack, and he finds Victor Cruz over the middle. And that was my fault. I should have been deeper in coverage on that play. I didn't expect an end route from Victor Cruz, and the Patriots have a first down across midfield. Now it's going to be first and 10 from the 36-yard line. I formation once again, handoff to the outside for Lacy. Room to run, but tackled after a gain of 4. And that's a nice job bringing down Lacy on my own. He cannot get loose in this game. That's exactly the kind of defense we need. Graham in motion to back up tight end. Handoff Lacy outside once again as he's brought down by the ankles by Prince Mukamara, and they'll lose one. That'll bring up 3rd down and 7, and now we have a chance to keep the Patriots to a field goal as Garoppolo will drop back, trying to find a receiver. He's staying in the pocket. He's firing downfield for Nicks, and Hakeem Nicks has the catch at the 13. That one's good for 20. I don't know how he made the catch, but apparently Garoppolo just put it where Prince Mukamara couldn't get it. That pass was high, and still Nicks came down 2 feet in bounds. That catch was legit. First and 10 from the 13. Garoppolo dropping back once again. He fires for the end zone for Nicks and is caught for a touchdown as Abraham Fitzgerald was just standing still as a stone. He didn't even see Hakeem Nicks run across him. Checking out the instant replay here, you'll see Nicks running right to left on the post route. And, I mean, Abraham Fitzgerald just standing still, not adjusting. And unfortunately, that's how we give up a touchdown on our first drive on defense. But our offense driving downfield, getting a touchdown of their own. So this game's tied up 7-7 still in the first. But Eddie Lacy through the air. Caught, good for 17 yards, getting them down to the 40. And we have got to contain Eddie Lacy. This guy's a dangerous runner and a receiver. as Graham's in motion once again, respecting an outside handoff for Lacy, but it's a counter, and Lacy to the left side of the field as he's going to get brought down. And luckily, that one only good for 6 yards. That's going to bring up third down and two. Big third down for the defense. Can we stop the Patriots here and get the ball back to our offense? But Dunbar on the outside carry gets away from Fitzgerald, and oh my goodness, he got the first. Fitzgerald had to stop, lost it, and Lance Dunbar good for six. And now we're in the second quarter, second and seven, as Garoppolo's in the shotgun. And he's going to draw back the pass, trying to find someone open, getting away from one, but brought down by Quentin Hobbs. And that's a big sack on second down, bringing up third down and 14. We get the stop here, and the Patriots have to punt. They're not in field goal range for Cody Parkey. Third and 14, shotgun once again as Garoppolo firing down the field for Gronk. And Gronk is too quick for Xavier Gooden. And a first down for the Patriots now at the 27-yard line. I should have been switching up coverage there, but I thought we could cover Gronk. Another handoff here for Lacy up the middle. That one's going to be stopped after a gain of a couple. And that'll bring up second down and seven. Split shotgun once again. Gronk in the backfield as Garoppolo drops back, trying to find someone open. He'll look for the end zone. This one's going to be caught by Cruz, and he's going to dance. The Salsa Man with a touchdown here in Tampa Bay. And the Patriots are now 2-for-2 with two touchdowns on their first two possessions. Princeton Mukamara man coverage. I thought we could handle Victor Cruz, but apparently not. And now the Patriots are up 14-7, and they're driving down the field once again at our 34. And man coverage against Gronk. I let him slip past. I thought he was going to be running up the field, but it was a slant route inside, and I give up the first. First and 10 from the 22. Handoff here for Lacy once again as he's going to carry up the field. Nice tackle there by Kyler Woodyard, and that keeps him to a couple yards, but the Patriots in the red zone once again. We have got to get a stop here. They cannot go up 21-7. I formation once again for the Patriots. Handoff outside for Lacy. He gets away from one, brought down after a gain of four. And that'll bring up third down and three. We've got to get the stop here. They come out in the I formation once again. We're expecting a run. The linebackers have to get pressure here as Lacy handoff to the outside once again. Amukamara stops him and I clean him up. And that's going to bring our fourth down and two. What a stop here in the red zone by the defense. Just what we needed as the Patriots were close to scoring another touchdown or keeping that drive going. But beautiful job by Amukamara applying pressure. And now it'll be a 31-yard field goal attempt for Cody Parkey, left hash. And this one's up. And it's good as the Patriots take a 17-7 lead here with 3:50 left in the first half. And with 2:54 left here in the first half, we're still down by 10, 17-7, and we've got to stop the Patriots here as they're trying to move down the field and get one more score before halftime. 2-minute warning approaching. Graham, the backup tight end in motion once again. Handoff outside for Lacy. He's ripped down, and that's good for no gain. That brings up third down and short, and we'll see what the Patriots do here. Do you throw, do you run? 2-minute warning just hit, and I'm betting they're going to throw the football. And Garoppolo drops back looking to pass. Pressure firing left side for Cruz, and it's intercepted by Amukamara. He's going to return it to the 49-yard line, and our offense with a short field has a chance to at least get a field goal here before halftime. What a job by Amukamara. That pass once again thrown high by Garoppolo, and this time Amukamara tracked it down in the air and cut it off before it hit the receiver's hands. These are the kind of plays on defense we need to make in order to win this game, but unfortunately our offense can't turn turnovers into points. And the Patriots have the ball back at the 9-yard line, minute 14 left, and they still have three timeouts. And Garoppolo firing short for Gronk, and Gronk goes down at the 11. That was a nasty hit on Gronk, and he is going to be injured holding that shoulder that he's had multiple surgeries on, and it does not look good for Gronk. On the sideline now, holding that shoulder, looking to be in quite a bit of pain, and the Patriots definitely need him, especially late in the season here, as they're trying to make a playoff push. But back on the field here, second and eight. Garoppolo firing short for Cruz, caught for 1 yard, and that's going to bring up third down and seven, and this is a big stop for our defense. We get the ball back to our offense. There's still time left for them to maybe get some points on the board. Third and seven, Garoppolo dropping back. I'm tired of him having all day to throw in the pocket. I'm bringing pressure, and he has to get rid of it quickly. That was nearly a sack, and that'll bring up fourth down and seven from the 12. Little under a minute left here, three timeouts. Our offense has plenty of time if they can just get the ball down the field and at least get a field goal. And this punt's going to be returned from just shy of the 30-yard line. Bring this one up the field, juke move, and my blockers just weren't blocking very well. That's going to give us 47 seconds left in the first half, and we get a field goal. So now we're only down by seven. And here goes the second half getting underway. Hand off outside Lacy, and he's going to get the carry. He's going to be stopped in the backfield for a loss of one. And what a stop there by Kyler Woodyard. These are the stops that we need. That brings up a big third down and nine. Let's get the lead back, or at least tie the game up. As Garoppolo drops back, no one open so far. And he's going to get taken down by Michael Johnson. Ran out of time. And that's going to bring up fourth down and 13. Big stop there. Everyone covered downfield. I covered the corner route or the post route first, and I tried to cover the in route. But by that time, Michael Johnson came in like a bulldozer and took down Garoppolo. And how does Jimmy Garoppolo get up from that hit? Michael Johnson's not a small dude. Well, neither is Garoppolo. He's like 6'4", I think. But our offense got the ball back, couldn't do anything with it. So now the Patriots have the ball at the 5, and Garoppolo getting it outside to Victor Cruz. That one good for 6. And that'll bring up 2nd down and 4. Definitely thought they would have been running in that situation, but here we go, 2nd and 4. Tight end in motion, handing off Lacy up the middle. He's got the first down, and that one's good for 5. Nearly had the stop, lost it. 1st and 10 from the 17 for the Patriots as the fullback's in motion. And handoff for Lacy here, and I nearly got to him in the backfield, but that's going to be a gain of 1. And that really should have been a loss of maybe 3 or 4 yards on a play, but 2nd down and 9. And a handoff, Lacy up the middle once again, getting away from 1, and he's going to get brought down after a gain of 3 as he shrugged off Xavier Gooden. That is not easy to do that. Many people do not get away from Xavier Gooden, and now we have a 3rd down and 6. Big 3rd down for the defense once again, inside of 4 minutes in the 3rd as Garoppolo drops back, no one open, firing outside for Graham, the backup tight end, and that's going to be good for a gain of 1, and that's going to bring a 4th down and 5. Nice tackle by Amukamara out there in open space. And we're going to get the ball back to our offense. But they don't do anything once again. Patriots with the ball further down the field at the 33-yard line on our side of the field. Hand off Lacy up the middle. I miss on the tackle. I can't believe it. Normally, I'm really good at those, but Lacy picks up 7. And now it's going to be 2nd down and 3. Garoppolo dropping back once again, trying to cover the slant routes. Pretty well covered. And Michael Johnson with the 2nd sack of the game. That brings up 3rd and 11. Can we get a stop here as we're at the 34-yard line? And it's going to be Graham in motion. And Garoppolo gets the ball, drops back the pass, looking for a receiver, and he's going to throw outside for Hakeem Nicks, and that is completely my fault. I wasn't looking for the out route. That was supposed to be my zone, and I left it open. I formation once again, Lacy to the outside, and he's upended after a gain of 1, and what a hit that was. That was pretty impressive, just completely leveling Eddie Lacy, and we're at the end of the 3rd quarter pretty much. 30 seconds left, ball at the 20-yard line, handoff Lacy, and he stopped immediately. What a tackle there by Cinderic Marks. This is what we need on defense. What pressure we got is Cinderic Marks. I don't think Cinderic Marks was blocked. I think the guard pulled and no one accounted for him. So now we have 3rd and 14, last play of the 3rd quarter as Garoppolo firing outside, and it's caught for a 1st down at the 8-yard line. We needed a stop there, and we could not get it. 1st and goal from the 8, starting the 4th quarter. Garoppolo going 5 wide. He'll draw it back to pass, looking for receivers open, bringing pressure, and he's ripped down by Quentin Hobbs for the 2nd time on the game. We desperately needed that sack. Gives us a little bit of breathing room. This is going to be 2nd down and goal. We have to keep them to a field goal as Lacy carries up once again, and that one is stopped after a gain of 2. So that's going to bring up 3rd down and goal. We've got to get a stop here as we're trying to keep the Patriots to a field goal. And the Patriots go 5 wide. Garoppolo firing outside to the flat for Nicks. Caught, and he's pushed out of bounds. What a tackle by Armand Gleers. That's what we needed. And the Patriots will have to kick a 20-yard field goal, and we're going to be happy with that. 20-10 lead here. 7:14 left. Our offense is failing us right now, and it's going to be up to the defense to get some type of stop as Lacy carries up the middle, gets away from me as I'm blocked down low, and that's going to be good for a gain of 9. 2nd down and 1 from the 17. We cannot let them continue to move this ball down the field. Hand off Lacy outside. He's got room to run, but ripped down by Amukamara once again in the backfield. And that's going to bring up 3rd down and 2. We need these stops. Our corners are playing beautifully today against the run. And Amukamara off that right side has done a wonderful job. And now we have 3rd down and 2 from the 16. Lance Dunbar in the backfield. He's going to get the carry off tackle. I get away from Reuben Randall, but it's not quick enough. As Dunbar has the 1st down, and this drive will continue for the Patriots. Inside of 6 minutes here, 5:35 left, as the Patriots will go to the ground once again with Dunbar up the middle, and that one good for 6. At some point, we might have to start burning timeouts, as the Patriots actually go 5 wide here, so they're not going to be running the football. They're going to be selling out on the pass. So we're going to switch out to a zone. And Garoppolo dropping back, trying to find someone open. He's throwing my direction. This one's intercepted at the 37-yard line. And this one's going all the way back for a touchdown. Why not just run the football? But thank you very much, Jimmy Garoppolo. Thank you very much. We can't celebrate too much because we're still down in this game, but that's going to get it a little closer, as that's going to be my second straight game with a pick six. He was going for Graham, and Graham was covered. I baited the throw just slightly, which I've been trying to do all season. I'm getting a little better at it, but we'll take a look at this play one more time. That was such a clutch audible, switching out of man-to-man and going to cover three, because that crossing route across the field, that was man-to-man coverage, and the AI was covering that. That would have been caught for a first down, but the cover three allowed me to be over there. I baited the throw from Garoppolo. I got the interception, took it back for a score, and we're only down by three. And the Buccaneers fans in the background, look at them. They're hyped. They know, hey, we have a chance here in the fourth quarter. A little under 5 minutes left. We have to make one more stop. And the offense gets a field goal, and this game is back at tied. That's all we're hoping for here, and hopefully we can get it done. Back on the field here on defense, 4:41 left. The Patriots, we know they're going to be running the football with Lacy. And Lacy up the middle of the field carries. He's got a first down, and that is not how we want to start out this potential final drive of this fourth quarter for the Patriots. We've got to get a stop here. First and 10, Garoppolo dropping back. We brought a blitz. It was man-to-man. And Dwayne Harris across the middle has another first down. That'll take us inside of 4 minutes. This is not what we want to do here on this possession. First and 10 here. Dunbar up the middle carrying. He stopped, and that's going to be a nice tackle there by Odrick, as that's going to keep them to 2 yards. Second down and 8 for the Patriots from the 44. And Lacy getting the carry to the outside of the field, getting away from Woodyer, but not getting away from Armand Gleers. What a tackle by the nickel corner as he came up and made a pretty impressive tackle on Eddie Lacy. Woodyer should have wrapped him up first, but that's a nice job there by Armand Gleers. And now we have third down and 9. Three receivers my side of the field. Thought they were going to set up a screen, but Michael Johnson gets free, and down goes Jimmy Garoppolo. 4th and 17. And we are close to the 2-minute warning here, so we're not going to call a timeout. We'll let the 2-minute warning hit and give our team 3 fresh timeouts to work with. And we'll see what we can do here on the punt return. This one's going to be punted from just inside the 25. As Locke booting this one down the field, is kicked into the end zone, and I'm just going to let this one go. There was a part of me that wanted to run that one all the way back for a touchdown, but let's just give the ball back to our offense with all the time I can, and they get the field goal, and we have 31 seconds left here with a tie game. But the Patriots, 2 timeouts left, going for the win as Garoppolo under center, dropping back, spinning all day in the pocket. He's taken down by Chato Uzogwu. That is a huge stop by our defense. Now the Patriots are probably going to run the football here with 24 seconds left. But we're going to keep calling timeouts. Second and 19, handoff for Lacy up the middle. He's going to get tripped up and pick up 5. And with that stop, we'll call our final timeout with 18 seconds left. Third and 14. And maybe the Patriots will want to throw the football here and stop the clock. Patriots come to the field here, 3rd and 14, I formation. Handoff for the running back, James White, in the backfield. He gets away from one, and the ball comes loose. And it's recovered by Xavier Gooden, and this game is over. Take it all away for the score. Touchdown. Why not just kneel the football? You're going to give it to your third-string running back at the end of the game. And I absolutely punished this dude. Oh, my goodness. What a finish. What a comeback. This has got to be the greatest game I've ever played. I mean, come on. Who saw this coming, really? I mean, come on. I mean, look at this. I mean, he gets away. One, he got away from Quint Hobbs, which I find ridiculous. He got away from Amuka Mara, but he was not getting away from that third hit. I mean, come on. I lowered the shoulder, and what a time to force a fumble in today's game. I mean, you talk about making an impact in the fourth quarter. The final 5 minutes of this game have been absolutely epic. The interception taken back for a touchdown, and then, of course, his fumble that was taken all the way back by Xavier Gooden, but, of course, forced by me. And my rookie campaign continues as we beat the Patriots in dramatic fashion, a comeback victory, 27-20. Our offense did pretty much nothing in the second half, but at least they weren't turning the football over like they've done in previous games. But, I mean, what a job by the defense in the second half, especially in the fourth quarter. Look at the scoring summary. Patriots put up 17 in the first half, only 3 in the fourth quarter. We put up 10 in the first half and 3 offensively in the fourth quarter, but 14 defensively in the fourth quarter. Like the experts predicted, this game went down to the wire, and it started off looking like it was going to be a big win for the Patriots. We couldn't stop them on the first 2 drives. Jimmy Garoppolo, 2 touchdowns. to Hakeem Nicks and Victor Cruz. But what a job by the defense. Fourth quarter, pick six at about the five-minute mark, and then we came back with the fumble recovery, which was the play of the game. And it wasn't the run back, it was the forced fumble. I mean, what a job. But why would the Patriots give the ball to James White? We'll talk about that a little later, but 11 tackles in the game, 10 solo, one interception taken back for 37 yards, and of course, the forced fumble that would ultimately give us the win. No overtime in today's game. Xavier Gooden, 7 tackles on the game, and he had that one fumble recovery that went back for 27 yards. Taking a look at everyone else's stats, Kyler Wardier, pretty solid game. Levante David had a good game. Armand Gleary with some clutch tackles on third down. Michael Johnson with some huge sacks in that second half. He had 3. Princeton Mukamara, 3 tackles, 4 total. The interception in the second quarter towards the end. And then Quentin Hobbs had 2 sacks as well. Chidi Uzoglu had that huge sack on their final possession for the Patriots that kind of forced them to start running the football because it didn't make any sense for them to try to force the ball down the field with only 24 seconds left. But I mean, what a job by our team. Altron Werner, only 1 tackle, wasn't too much of a factor in today's game. Mike Glennon, 81.5 QB rating, 26-41 for 282 yards, 1 touchdown, 1 interception. I don't know when the interception happened, but it didn't really impact us too much. Longest pass, 24 yards. Doug Martin, this is probably one reason why this game was so close. 10 carries for 38 yards. Doug Martin hasn't rushed for under, I think, 100 yards this entire season, which is kind of weird. Stevie Johnson, 8 catches, 113 yards, 1 touchdown. Mike Evans, how are we heading in the week 13 and Mike Evans still doesn't have a receiving touchdown? 4 catches, 62 yards on the game for him. Jermaine Curse, 3 for 32. Drew Davis, 1 for 6. Jimmy Garoppolo had a pretty solid game. 97.4 QB rating, 20 of 23 for 210 yards. Very efficient, threw 86%, 2 touchdowns. But of course, 2 interceptions that probably hurt the team. The one that hurt the most probably coming in the fourth quarter, as they probably should have been running the football with 5 minutes left. Eddie Lacy on the ground, 28 carries, 94 yards. Lance Dunbar, 6 for 21. And then, of course, James White, his first carry of the game went for 1 yard, and he coughed up the football. But if you notice on that play, Eddie Lacy was on the field on that final play. He was in at fullback, which I don't understand. Why would you have Eddie Lacy at fullback and give the ball to your third-string running back? I have no idea what formation that is, but I want to see more teams run it. Give the ball to your third-string running back at the end of the game and let me force a fumble. Gronk did not return in this game, so we'll check on his injury status a little later in the game. Victor Cruz had a solid game. I mean, pretty much Jimmy Garoppolo had a pretty decent game. You saw he was very efficient, minus the interceptions, and that's kind of how today's game went. Looking at the total yardage, we did a pretty good job. Total offensive yards, we won, but rushing on the ground, only 37 yards. That is very not like our offense at all. The Patriots had 3 turnovers today, 2 interceptions, and of course the forced fumble. On third downs, both teams pretty bad. Patriots 6 of 14 for 42%. We were 4 of 12 for 33%. We had 1 failed fourth down conversion. I'm pretty sure that was one of those drives where we had the ball like the 5 or the 9 yard line. It was either one of those. And the Patriots in the red zone, 4 out of 4, 2 touchdowns and 2 field goals, and time of possession, 30 for the Patriots and under 10 for us. 6 sacks on Jimmy Garoppolo, 3 takeaways. Mike Glennon sacked 3 times, and they had 1 takeaway on him via the interception. But milestones reached in the game, 1 interception, 10 tackles in the game, score a defensive touchdown, and I finally get my milestone for 100 tackles on the season, which I acquired last week, but I guess it waits a week to give it to you. So hopping into week 13, rematch against the Saints, who we just played in week 11. And this game could very well end up being worse for the Saints than it was in week 11. I mean, you look at their offensive numbers. They've dropped back in both offense and defense, and we've been moving up. And in week 11, Doug Martin ran for 150 yards on the ground, so we're definitely looking for a repeat performance from week 11 and not from week 12. And the headline for this team every week is our offense, but look at Skip Bayless showing me some love down in the Twitter section. Greg Robertson is critical for his team's success on D each week. NFC Defensive Player of the Week. And checking in on the injury for Gronk, he's going to be out for 4 weeks. I put Gronk out for 4 weeks with a shoulder tear, so it was the shoulder once again, and that's not good. He should be back right in time for the playoffs, but you kind of have to wonder how the Patriots will fare without him. And now we'll take a look at the annual award rankings here in week 13 as Doug Martin leads things off for MVP, followed by Andy Dalton, Aaron Rodgers, Andrew Luck, Mike Glennon on here, Amon Middlebrooks, LeSean McCoy, Russell Wilson, Jimmy Garoppolo, And then all the way at number 10, I'm number 10 in MVP ranking. I'm on the board at least. That is epic. And let's see how far I can get up this board with the remaining weeks we have this season. Coach of the Year led by Mike McCarthy, Lovie Smith in second place, Chuck Pagano of the Colts, Rex Ryan of the Seahawks, Marvin Lewis, Bengals, Chip Kelly of the Eagles, Jeff Fisher of the Patriots, Mike Pettine of the Browns, and then you have Harold Tibbetts of the Jets, and then John Fox of the Broncos down at 10. Offensive Player of the Year led by Doug Martin, LeSean McCoy, Aaron Rodgers, Garrett Neal of the Cowboys, Russell Wilson of the Seahawks. Down at number 5, Mike Glennon at 6, Robert Griffin III of the Redskins, Austin Davis of the Eagles, Colin Kaepernick, and then Teddy Bridgewater of the Vikings. Defensive Player of the Year, led by myself, followed by Bobby Wagner of the Seahawks, Michael Kendricks, Stephen Tulloch, Jarius Byrd of the Saints, Zach Brown, Xavier Gooden's on this list as well, and then you have Luke Kuechly, and then Akeem Jordan, and then Abraham Fitzgerald is on this list. I don't know why. Why won't you have players like Michael Johnson or some other people? Taking a look at Offensive Rookie of the Year, led by Niall Priester of the Sacramento Condors, Jeff Bray of the Packers, Will Fedrick, Wesley Hall of the Lions, then you have Bill Smith of the Eagles, Cornelius Cross of the Cardinals, Julian Morales of the Lions, Darius Newton of the Cardinals, Blaine McKay, and then at 10 you have Anfernee Peppers of the Eagles. I'm leading Defensive Rookie of the Year, followed by Juwan Meyer of the Bears, Arnold of the Redskins, LaRon Lindley of the Lions, Linville McClam of the Bears as well. So the Bears have some pretty solid pieces with their rookie defensive players. Hopefully they can get a little better in the upcoming seasons. Maybe I'll go back home to Chicago at the end of my contract. Best quarterback, Aaron Rodgers leading this, Mike Glennon, Austin Davis of the Eagles, Russell Wilson, Teddy Bridgewater, Garrett Neal, RG3, Ryan Mallett, Matt Stafford, And Colin Kaepernick. Are you serious? This is so rigged. Best running back, Doug Martin, LeSean McCoy, Terry McKenzie of the Cardinals, Carlos Hyde taking over for Frank Gore. He's in Dallas. Adrian Peterson, Chris Ivory, Alfred Morris, Stephen Ridley, Marshawn Lynch, beast mode. About that business, boss. And then Daryl Richardson of the Redskins. Calvin Johnson leading things for best wide receiver. Jordy Nelson, Stevie Johnson on this list at number 3. Brandon LaFell, Brian Quick, O'Neal Tolliver of the Packers, Julian Edelman, T.Y. Hilton was on there as well, Dez Bryant, and then Golden Tate. So Julian Edelman is leading things for the Dallas Cowboys, it looks like. Taking a look at best offensive line, Williams, Warford, Bowers, Upati, I think that's how you pronounce that, Davis, Staley, Sitton, Knox, and then Velder of the Bears. Best defensive line, all these Buccaneers in the top 4. Michael Johnson, Quentin Hobbs, Gerald McCoy, and Sendarik Marks. Cameron Jordan, Ndamukong Suh, Marquise Hamilton, Fletcher Cox, Calais Campbell, and then Detone Jones. It's a cool name. Best defensive back in the NFC, obviously led by me, followed by Jarius Byrd, Tim Jennings of the Bears, Leon Hall of the Redskins, Marshall Arnold, Prince Mukamara on here as well, nice. Casey Hayward of the Packers, Janoris Jenkins of the Condors, Cam Chancellor, and then Sam Shields. Best kicker, Dustin Hill of the Buccaneers, not bad. Followed by Graham Gano, Mason Crosby, Dan Bailey, Josh Scobie, Kai Forbath, Blair Walsh, and then you have Chandler Catanzaro, Connor Barve, and then Alex Henry of the 49ers. Taking a look at AFC Offensive Player of the Year, Andy Dalton, Armon Middlebrooks, Andrew Luck, Eddie Lacy, Garoppolo, Flacco, AJ Green, Zach Dysart, Giuseppe Williams, and then Blake Bortles. Defensive Player of the Year, C.J. Mosley, Derek Johnson, Jared Mayo, Brandon Spikes, Butler, Cushing, Lawrence Timmons, Justin Houston, Ryan Shazier, and then Tashaun Gibson. Offensive Rookie of the Year led by Trey Watkins, quarterback for the Buffalo Bills. Sadarius Small is actually drafted by the Colts in this series. They're 9-2, so he's number 2 on the list. And then Grady Langford of the Patriots, Brett Walters of the Patriots, Branch Parcham. Defensive Rookie of the Year, Moon, Dixon, Malone, Chapham, Arnold, Lucas, Daniel, Bradley, and then Paul Dixon of the Titans. Best quarterback led by Andy Dalton, Andrew Luck, Jimmy Garoppolo, Armon Middlebrooks on this list. I don't know how. Zach Dysart, we destroyed the Jets. Thad Lewis of the Chiefs, Trey Watkins, Romel Strong, and then Giuseppe Williams once again at the bottom of the list. Best running back led by Eddie Lacy. So we did a good job of shutting down Lacy. And I talked to someone about this. in the last quarterback episode, but Dexter McCluster is actually starting for the Chargers on this series. I don't know what happened between this one and the last one, but it's kind of weird how they kind of switched around. Taking a look at best wide receiver, a lot of familiar names there. Za'Darius Small up on the list for best wide receiver. And Justin Blackmon, just like in my series, was picked up by the Chargers. That's kind of weird. Joe Thomas, best offensive lineman, leading things off. Alex Mack on the list as well. Eric Fisher, Kevin Zietler, Anthony Costanzo, Luis Vasquez, and then Ryan Clady all the way down to number 10. Best defensive line, Emmanuel Robinson, J.J. Watt, Carlos Dunlap, Jamie Collins. Familiar names on here, Marcus Hunt, Chandler Jones, Khalil Mack. Doing a little better in this series than he is on the quarterback side. I think he's all the way down to number 10 for best defensive line in my series. Best defensive back led by Gibson, Cyprian, McCourty, Harris Jr., Chris Harris Jr. Did I get it right this time? Best kicker led off by Sean Sweezum, Justin Tucker, Matt Prater, Cody Parkey, Steven Middlebrooks, Patrick Murray, Nick Novak, Ryan Succop, Dan Carpenter, and then Heath Wallace. So that'll do it. We'll take one more look at the MVP stuff and all that stuff towards the end of the season when it should be announced. I believe that it might actually be after the Super Bowl. I'm not entirely too sure how it does it in Madden. But up next, 10-1 Buccaneers against the 3-8 New Orleans Saints. This is one of the last two NFC South matchups we have. We have one more game against the Carolina Panthers, and we only have four more weeks left in the regular season. So we should be wrapping up things pretty quickly here. But thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. And let's go out there and get that MVP. I couldn't win a Heisman, but let's get the MVP. See you guys later. Thanks for watching.